With Cursor AI being all the rage now and GitHub's Copilot just announcing their own integration, the LLM coding wars are stepping up. 9-year-olds can now build their own websites and have Cursor do most of the heavy lifting. If we're totally honest, this isn't really the case as you still need some know-how, but if you haven't watched this video, it's a real mind scratcher and gives you a good vibe of where we're going. All that said, at the end of the day, even Cursor is just a VS Code fork. Why can't real developers working with Neovim join the party without suffering at the hands of GUIs and mice? Well, that's no longer the case. Today, we're going to configure Neovim to not only complete the code for us, but rather write it instead of us. We're going to make Neovim a better Cursor AI, so that 9-year-olds can work with real IDEs and not embarrass themselves in school the next day. I need some good coffee before starting the mess with my Neovim config again, because it's been a minute. Plugins for Neovim, especially with all the AI craze, are popping like wild mushrooms, and picking something that's really moving the needle is quite the challenge. So, where do you find such a special project? I recently installed Cursor. Yes, I have a type of VS Code on my machine, I'll go see a doctor when we're done, but I had to see what the fuss is all about. So after using Claude quite heavily, I'm tired of the code copy-pasting, and I'm more tired of Claude not being able to add my changes to its context. I came to hear about Avante a while ago, and with its promises and growing popularity, it's time for me to give it a proper go. If I got it correctly, Avante means ahead in Spanish and pronounced Avante. Felt like Ehrlich Bachmann for a second there.
Aviato.
Anyway, Avante wants to do to Neovim what Cursor did to VS Code, by simply iterating on the same context using a simple UI and a few key combos. You provide the code, or simply let it write it from scratch, and then keep iterating using natural language. Pretty simple in terms of UX, but rather complicated when it comes to implementation. Installing with Lazy is pretty straightforward, just grab the config as is and add it to Lazy. I didn't bother with changes at this stage, I just want to see if it does the job first. So, adding to Lazy, making sure everything is nice and tidy, and then running HMS, which, although sounds like a disease, is my solution for running Home Manager switch when I update my .dot files, more on that in the video above. Now for the real work. I want to start off by building something from scratch, and as weird as it is, the first thing that comes to mind is a router website, which I don't even know what means. But anyway, let's let Cursor, sorry, Avante, figure it out. Neovim pops up Lazy, and also grabs the list of dependencies for Avante to function, but also look nice when rendering Markdown on the side panel. If you start typing Avante in your commands and have a tab completion, there are a bunch of options. The most useful and common one is Avante Ask. That works as you'd expect from any LLM you've spoken to. There's a small prompt for your poetry, and once your instructions are ready, you send it. Pop Avante into insert mode and type away. In this instance, I'll create a cool landing page for my router company, because what's cooler than that? The plugin lists timestamp, the model in use, and received prompt. Do note that you'd need an API key to work with. I got mine from Claude, which is the default provider, but the configuration can take any of the major ones, which you then either provide as an API key through this panel, or like I did by exposing an environment variable that it can read. When it's done generating, you'd see a red message clarifying it's ready for further instructions, often asking you what's next. There's a lot of code suggestions above, but since we're creating from scratch, I'm not going to bother with reviewing it. Take it all by hitting capital A, making Avante inject the changes into the workspace buffer, and now it's my job to approve the change, reject it, or take bits of it. I'll go again with the default take everything from the AI by hitting CA, which I memorized as change all. And let's look at that HTML file in the browser. I'll open the current working directory, and yes, this goes through bash since I'm currently running NuShell, more on that in the video above. There's the file, now let's open it to unravel our newly created company. Next Gen Networking Solutions. Apparently we sell router tech that's highly performant, comes with advanced security, and is easy to set up. What's not to like? We got a nice smooth in-page linking, placeholder for products, and even a contact form with input validation. Now let's make Avante's life harder and try to implement authentication. Let's add a login button and integrate it with Auth0 since they now offer probably the biggest free of charge user pool. After some thinking, and by the way, you can travel back and forth between the prompt and the cogen buffer using tab, the results are starting to come in. We'll wait patiently for completion and check out the instructions when it's done. I'd need an Auth0 account, a new app and a couple of values probably generated in the Auth0 dashboard after we sign up. Lastly, the most annoying bug of all when testing locally an authentication solution, callback URLs that should be approved on localhost, but we'll get to that. All right then, let's accept the changes again by hitting capital A to take everything and then CA to change all the diffs in the working buffer. A quick refresh before setting things up. There's our login button that's not really doing anything at the moment because there's no domain set. So, auth0.com, like I said, 25,000 free users, no credit card required, so hit start building for free, and yes, naturally this process would work with any other provider. Let's sign up, go to applications, create a new one for the router company, and choose a single page JavaScript application. Conveniently, Auth0 comes with example code bases for every language or framework, but I don't really care about it as I have someone writing it all for me. And here's the settings that we have to get right for the local test to work. Localhost at port 3000 needs to be set here before it'll get accepted. The port doesn't really make any difference, that's just the common JavaScript port to serve on. I'll create my own app in a second for that as well. Go to settings, throw that localhost 3000 endpoint everywhere, including allowed callbacks, allowed logout URLs, and allowed web origins. Save the changes and move back up for the client ID and domain. You could play with the settings later, adding more authentication methods, social connections, and more. For now, GitHub and user pass only. So let's get Avante the domain and ID that asked for, replace both in the code, and hopefully that's going to be enough for our router company login. So we can run our page, but there is one small issue with this. We have localhost set as the URL, and this page isn't actually served by anything. It's just a plain HTML file in the browser. What do we have a CodeGen framework for? Let's create a server. I'm always choosing Go, but it doesn't really matter when it's written for me. Anyway, let's open main.go and ask Avante to create a simple Go server that serves index.html on localhost 3000. Capital A to accept everything, CA to approve the diffs, and there's a small bug, and here's where we get the edges of AI. At some point, you're going to need a human eyes on the code both to approve and adjust. My server does everything correctly, it just decided to serve it in the directory called static on its own. Since I don't have one, let's just serve it on the local directory where index.html is also held, run again, and there we are. Moment of truth, login. And what do you know? An authorization panel. The router app is requesting access to my account. Sure. By the way, Auth0 were kind enough to sponsor this video, so if you want to get started for free, check out the link in the description. Okay, that's it. I'm logged in. How do I know? Because the button says log out. Not ideal, is it? Let's tweak it a bit with Avante asking that once logged in, add a welcoming message on top with my name and avatar. Cool. Accept suggestions, accept the changes, and let's go. Log in and voila. Welcome, hi at OmerXX. Let's use another login method to see social names and avatars if they work. Using my GitHub account, accept to authorize the domain, and nice, welcoming me and my GitHub avatar. Everything works. Let's fix a few rough edges and ask it to make it a bit more stylish and colorful so that our customers feel invited. Maybe even use my beloved Cappuccino mocha palette. Accept, accept, reload, and yep, looking good. Even the social welcoming message looks more natural. We can even ask it to use random images for the product instead of the non-existing placeholders, and yes, it seems we're also selling a Mercedes 4x4 in our line of offerings. Like I said, we can go on and expand authentication by adding more platforms like Google, for example, allowing for another type of login without changing the code at all. So that's pretty nice to have, and looking like it's working out of the box minus the missing avatar. But I think we've done enough. I can go on to the DevOpsy side of things, creating a Docker file and asking Avante to fill in the details, which for some reason it had interpreted with Python, but that still works. This is an important bit. By default, Avante only has the context of your file, not the entire project. But with a very recent addition it got, you can now actually chat with the entire project by tagging @codebase before your prompt. Let's see how this works. Avante chat and ask what can be improved in the project. Here's a list of suggestions, but it starts by saying that it doesn't see any of the code provided. So let's tag codebase and ask again what can be improved in my application. And there we have it, a long markdown page with code block suggestions, testing, documentation, maintenance, etc. This is, of course, just the tip of the iceberg and a super simple use case for this technology. Let me know your thoughts if you've given it a try.
Avante does most of the work for you, but unfortunately, it's going to take some time until you can trust its capabilities in full. Until then, you're going to have to accept some changes and reject others. When you do reject some, you're going to want an excellent code completion to potentially help you fix bugs and breeze through changes you have to manually fix. I just realized I called writing code a manual task as if code gen is the obvious. Anyway, watch this next video to pair yourself with the perfect code companion from a wide range of options that I'll let you narrow down. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you on the next one.